Hello everyone, this is my highlight and contouring video. I already put my foundation on. The foundation I used was Lancome Tint Idol in the color 460W, and I'm using LA Pro Girl Concealer in the color Fawn, and I could not get it out. Like, I don't know what was going on. Just, Jesus. So, putting in the little triangle, if you will, right under my eyes, and this is the part you want to highlight, so this is the part you want to bring out. Like, any facial feature that you would like to bring out, you would highlight. My chin, my cupid bow, the bridge of my nose, my forehead, and I like a lot on my forehead because I like my forehead to look just a little bit bigger, or just, I don't know, and a little bit under your contour area, just to make your contour pop. And here's my Real Techniques sponge, and I'm going to blend that out. And you kind of want to work quick because LA Pro Girl Concealer, it doesn't blend out very well if you let it set. So, yeah. Blend. And I'm blending it on my forehead. If you have a bigger forehead, just, you know, don't put as much concealer as I put on. Just put the contour a little more than the concealer. So you can either use the Lancome Mannequin Complete, I think that's how you say it, I'm not sure. Or you can use the LA Pro Girl. I decided to use the LA Pro Girl in this video so you could actually see, because the Lancome tends to be a little bit sheer, which I like for a day-to-day look. So just sucking your cheeks, and that's exactly where you put the contour. I'm doing lines up so I can easily blend the contour up. If your contour is too low, it starts to make your face droop, I guess. So you want a face lift, you don't want a droopy face. And I'm putting it around my perimeter of my face so I can blend my foundation in. And I'm doing my nose contour, which I usually don't do. I don't even know why I did it today, but I did it. So I'm blending this out. And honestly, if I were to do this again, I would not use the LA Pro Girl because it was like, it was so hard to blend. The blending took me like 1,831 hours. No, but you have to be very sparing with this if you want to use it for your contour day to day, and work fast and make sure your sponge is damp. But we'll get it done. Blend, honey, blend. We don't want to see no lines. We're going to blend this out. Yes. And I'm blending that nose contour. Boom, boom, boom. I don't know why I keep shaking my head like that, but I was happy. Mama. I put a little bit more of the highlight because I felt like it was disappearing. So I'm still going to blend that contour out. Like I told you, that contour was hard to blend. So I'm using Sasha Buttercup Powder, and I'm going to put that everywhere I highlighted. And I'm just going to set my highlighted place, keep it from melting off of my face, keep it bright, make my highlight brighter if you thought my highlight wasn't bright enough. So I'm putting that right over the concealer. And make sure you press it under your eye where you might have lines at, and to keep your concealer from creasing. I'm going to use the baking technique, which I know you heard of. And if you haven't, it's just a technique where you put the a lot of powder on your face. And this is supposed to set your concealer and brighten it up. And it's very, very, very full coverage. And just gives you a flawless finish. Usually, for a day-to-day basis, I would not bake because baking can be a little bit heavy. But if you were doing this for a day-to-day look, you can just press a little powder, not as much as I put on in the video. Pat, pat, pat. Pack it up, girl. Cake face, yeah. I'm just brushing my eyebrows up. I am doing my makeup in this section, and I didn't really want this video to be too long, so I know this looks really choppy, but I'm just gonna let this skip right here, because this is not a full face tutorial. This is just how to highlight and contour, as I said at the beginning of this video. Yes, that's my favorite palette, Morphe. Is that 35W? I love that palette so much, and I have pieces that are falling out. Look, I should have cleaned my stuff before I did this video, but I just forgot. I'm sorry. Forgetting. Yeah, I just did a really natural look. The light does not give any justice. Does not show how well it looks in person. Trust me, it looks bomb. You know, it looks bomb. But in this video, I'm looking kind of. So I'm blending this powder out. I'm using this e.l.f. powder brush, and that's the same thing I use for my foundation. And I'm just blending that powder out, because ain't nobody trying to look like no ghost. But yes, we are blending the powder out. Yeah, that's how you blend. Excuse all the faces that I'm making in this video, but I had to go. So you can either use the Black Radiance powder or the NYX powder. This color is hollow, and you can get it from the NYX website. Or you might find it in any stores that carry NYX. And the color of the black, they're dupes basically. And the color for the Black Radiance is Rich Mahogany. And they look exact same to me. I just wanted to try the NYX. And I've never seen anybody really use the NYX, so I wanted to use the NYX. So I'm just putting that everywhere I contour it at. And it's just gonna deepen my contour. Just make a look all, structured and whatnot, you know. I know I'm playing with the lights, y'all. I'm sorry. I don't know why I was doing that, but I did. Blend that out, girl. Yes. Yes, girl. Yes. And I'm using my Laura Tantalizing Bronzer. I'm sorry it looks a little dirty. And I'm using this e.l.f. blush brush. And I'm putting it at the highest points of my face. Oh, my cheeks. The highest points of my cheeks. And that's just going to give you that good shine. Like, you know when people be taking the pictures and that glisten be right up there? That's how you're going to get it. Bring back some life into the skin. So it doesn't look as powdery. And I love to put it on the two lines of my cupid's bow and the tip part of your lip. Like the top part of your lip. And I'm going to put a little more because I just love me some highlight. And I know it don't look blended here, but like, trust me, it's blended in real life. I'm going to blend it a little more. So I put some lashes on. I put some lipstick on, and this is how it is. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And here's the final look. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at LoveReach. And I hope you guys enjoyed my video. My Instagram and Twitter will be in the description box. So make sure you guys follow me. Here's the pictures at the end. I hope you guys enjoy it. And the lip color I do have on is this NYX brown. It's Dubai and another NYX lipstick. I'll put that in the description as well. And who requested this video? My cousin Daphne. She requested the video. So I hope you guys enjoy. Bye-bye.